Pension from Canine Vitality, back this week with the lovely Jenny Goldsby, back again to talk today about harnesses. Why, you might ask? Well, Jenny, as you know, Jenny runs the Complete Pet Company and Complete Canine Communication, and along with that work that she does with Complete Canine Communication is a lot of work revolving around correct harnesses and leads. So I thought I might have a little chat to Jenny today about harnesses. Now, Jenny, there are a lot of different opinions around collars versus harnesses versus leads. I know this will be a bit, sorry, versus halters, this will be a bit contentious when I put this video up, but I would really love your opinion because I know it'll be an expert opinion on this subject about what's the best thing to use on our dogs.
Oh, watch out. Okay, so first of all, can I say, you know, we've all done it. When you're desperate, and you know your dog's pulling you down the street and it's lunging at other dogs, you'll do whatever you have to do to try and
absolutely
control the dog. So first of all, if we talk about the halty, that's one of the gadgets that I really don't like. It's pretty obvious the damage that they do to dogs. You've only just got to look at them, and not only the damage they do to dogs, just how jolly uncomfortable they are.
Mm.
I mean, it's so unnatural for a dog to have something, you know, stuck around its muzzle, around the back of its head, and just looking at the damage that it does, you know, we see halties where, you know, it's actually sitting right up under the eye.
Mm.
Dogs have actually lost their eyes. I know of trainers that have told me dogs have had their jaws broken on these things, not to mention the damage to the neck. So they just really are a torture gadget.
Mm.
And, you know, dogs have their nose on the ground for most of the time, whereas we're taught to hold these leads up so that dogs, you know, can't basically move their head around. Then if we move to things like collars and check chains or those sorts of things, again, they're doing a lot of damage to the dog's neck. There's a lot of vital organs in there. Apart from all of that, though, Lingle, it's really disrespectful. I can't imagine being walked around by the neck.
Mm.
You know, I quite often look at dogs being walked on collars, even just a flat collar, and I always think, you know, that it's almost, I don't know what the word is, but it's just disrespectful to think that we're, you know, dragging these dogs around on collars. And then again, there's other harnesses. There's lots and lots and lots. There's so many harnesses on the market.
Yeah.
I'm actually collecting harnesses. I've got quite a few of them now. I've probably got about 15, I'd say, different harnesses.
Yep, that's true. You have them.
I do. And so when we look at how the harness fits on the dog, we see, you know, that it's sitting up way too high on the dog's neck. It's sitting too close behind the front legs. They're just uncomfortable. But they're also sitting on vital organs.
And that's interesting too, isn't it, Jenny? Because I know a lot of you out there will probably have dogs that suffer from recurrent ear infections. You may have a dog that's been diagnosed with thyroid condition. You may have a dog that's suffering from some sort of a structural problem like arthritis or some sort of a joint issue. And all of those problems can be made worse by either using a halty, a collar, or a poor-fitting harness because of the pressure that they're placing around the neck and the restriction to all those, as you say, those vital organs of the thyroid, all the lymph and blood flow, etc. So even from a health perspective, they're not good news, are they?
No.
So, and I just want to...
They're just uncomfortable too.
They are. And it's so true when you do see people walking their dog, particularly on a collar, often that the dog can be pulled, even though the owner may not seem like, you know, may not be purposely pulling. But I just wanted to touch on a point you said before too about the thing about getting their nose to the ground. Why is that important?
Because that's how dogs see the world, you know. The nose is the nose knows.
Mm.
It's just so important, you know. Everything a dog does is with its nose. So when dogs are walking, they will have their nose on the ground if they're allowed. It's quite sad to see dogs that are being made to walk in a heel position beside their owner and unable to smell what's been there before them and what's coming there after them.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's the nose on the ground is everything, absolutely everything.
And I understand too that from a stress perspective that's so critical to
absolutely
help, reduce the stress levels. So.
Yes, of course, because when they're sniffing, they feel good, and when they feel good, they're releasing those feel-good hormones. Mm. So that's extremely important. It's very similar to us, you know, knitting or doing yoga or meditation. It's something dogs love to do. They love to sniff.
Yeah, so, for those of you who've got dogs that are suffering from stress anxiety type problems, even just allowing those noses to get down on the ground and sniff can help lower those stress hormones down as well. So. Now, Jenny, you recommend only one type of harness and the one that you stock in the shop. What's the harness and why do you recommend just that one particular harness?
The harness that I recommend is the Hakiana harness. It's made in Italy. It's handmade in Italy. We are the Australian distributor for these harnesses now, which is really wonderful. They come in incredible colours, and the webbing is so soft. It's a beautiful, soft, pliable material. So apart from all those sorts of things, it actually sits really well on the dog. So there's a few vital points that we need to look at. Of course, we talked about vital organs within the dog's neck. So with the Hakiana harness, it actually does sit down very, very low in the front. It's got this beautiful Y, so it sits down low on the sternum bone. And that's really important because it means if the dog does pull for any reason, that this Y actually will touch the sternum bone and not these vital organs in the neck. And that's one of the big differences with the Hakiana harness and most harnesses on the market. Most of them are sitting up way too high. The second thing I really love about this harness is the way that it sits right back from the front legs. Mm. And that's really important. So as you can see, it's not sitting up tight on the elbows, which means that there's lots of freedom to move. The dog's not being pinched at all. It's got a nice H shape on the back here. So it sits right back from the wither of the dog. And this is where we clip the lead onto. So it's just a really nice fitting harness. It allows freedom of movement. The dog's not put under any pain. And we just see dogs calm down, settle down, and enjoy walks once they've put on these beautiful harnesses.
And also, they're incredibly good quality, aren't they?
Extremely good quality.
They tend to... I've had mine now for a few years on my dogs, and they just last and last. And
they do.
They don't even fray or anything like that, so they're fantastic quality. As well, a great investment. So, now, along with a really good fitting harness, a lot of your work within your workshop, you do a lot of lead work, and I know that as a dog owner that is guilty of having her dogs on a very short lead for fear of them pulling, why do you recommend long lead? Because I know you love to advocate long leads.
Oh yeah, I love long leads. We don't use anything and we don't sell any leads in here under 4 meters. That's really important. And luckily the Hakiana leads come in a 3 meter lead and up to the 10 meter lead. So this is a really, really long lead, and it's a beautiful color, as you can see, purple, which is the color of the Complete Pet Company. Mm-hmm. And the length of the lead is really important because it means that we can get these dogs on a long lead, and people that attend the workshop learn all about observation. So that's about keeping the mouth closed and opening the eyes and seeing what our dogs are up to. Mm-hmm. So when we put dogs on long leads, we can allow dogs to sniff so they can move out in front, they can move at their own speed, they can stop, they can start, they've got freedom to explore, freedom to be curious, they've got freedom to express themselves with other dogs, other people, move out of situations they're not comfortable with. So the long lead provides dogs to make good choices. And usually when we let dogs make choices, they are good choices. It's sniffing, and sniffing is so important. So it just means we can just hang off the back of the lead, keep it off the ground, bring it in when we need to, and let it out when we need to, and just let dogs be dogs and enjoy their walk.
So for the dog owners out there who... Because one of the biggest complaints I think dog owners have about walking their dog is the thing of the dog
pulling.
The pulling, which of course I've had experience myself with, and hence the short lead. So I guess when we understand how to work with the lead and have the proper fitting harness, the two together, that essentially eliminates a lot of those issues when we understand all that. So
just by putting the harness on the dog alone, that stops a lot of the pulling, because the dog's comfortable. It doesn't want to get away from you. It's not being in pain anymore, and you're not pulling back. And then by popping this long lead on, just creates that, like I said, freedom.
Which is so important, isn't it?
Yeah.
Now, how can listeners get hold of a harness here? Because obviously we sell them here in the shop, but and I know you take quite a lot of time when someone comes in with their dog to actually fit the harness properly, not just come in and buy and goodbye. Mm. So there's a lot that goes in with that. So how can listeners get on to buying one of your harnesses?
Sure. Obviously, like you just said, people that are local, they can come in and we can fit the dog. And it does take quite a while because I'm actually very fussy. Mm. I like to test drive it, make sure it's a really, really good fit. If you're not local to the Complete Pet Company, we can send them out. They are on our shop, which is completepet.com.au, and you just go to the shop online and you can order your harness there. You can always contact us via phone to ask if the exact size that you need. We also have stockers, so you can contact us about that as well. We can put you in touch with the stockers that are carrying these beautiful harnesses.
Yeah, it's great to know. Great to know that we can have the harness that will last, and you'll be, you'll just be doing such a great thing for your dog by changing over. So
we'll also, sorry, Linda, I just wanted to say too, for those of you that might be going to the Dog Lovers Show in November, we will have the Hakiana harness there. You will be able to come along and feel it, feel it, see it, touch it. You can even sniff it if you like. So it'll be there for you to have a look at.
Yes, and that's coming up in early November in Brisbane. So look out for that. There'll be details about the Dog Lovers Show on your website, I would imagine, Jenny.
Page. We've got on the Facebook page. Yep. There will be, and there's other things coming up as well. But that would be. There's a Dog Lovers website. You can go on there and read about the Complete Pet Company. But, the harnesses will be there.
That's great. Well, thanks, Jenny, for sharing that, because I think that's something that's important for dog owners to understand, because we do just sort of, when we get our dogs or bring them into our lives, we often just go down to the pet shop and buy a collar and lead. Don't really, to be honest, when I've done it in the past, I haven't really thought too much about it other than the collar. But, the importance of getting the right harness on your dog and the right, the right apparatus, I guess, and the right lead to have them in the most comfortable position. So thanks again, Jenny, for that. Thank you also to Spike, who I forgot to introduce in the beginning, but this is the lovely Spike who spends most of his time here in the shop, but he does also do a little bit of travelling along with Jenny when she's out and about. So he's been very good today, to be very quiet.
He's a good boy, isn't he?
He's very low maintenance too. So. thanks guys for watching. Don't forget to like, comment or share this post, and subscribe to my YouTube channel for all the latest updates. And I'll catch up with you next week with another blog. But for now, we'll say goodbye and look forward to talking to you very soon. Bye for now.
Bye.